everyone, welcome to my channel. So today I want to share the bags and SLGs that I've sold since last year and kind of talk about why. I don't like keeping things if they're not being used and collecting dust in my closet, and I'd like to keep my collection somewhat small. I'll link everything that I mentioned in this video in the description box below, and let's get started. First bag I sold was a Tory Burch Perry Bomb mini bag. I've had this bag for about a year and a half and used it almost every day. Wear and tear on the bag was amazing, and the size was kind of perfect for running errands and taking it to trips because it would fit in my travel bag easily. The main reason I sold it was because of the double zip, and the space was limited because of that. You know, last year with the pandemic, we had to carry masks and hand sanitizers and other stuff. It was just too small to carry everything. So I ended up selling the bag, but it was such a cute, compact bag that I would still recommend it to people if they're looking for an everyday mini bag. The next bag I sold was an Angela Roy bucket bag. This bag was a perfect everyday bag size, and it was made with vegan leather and very durable. It was very easy to style, and I loved the minimalistic look. However, it only had this one snap button closure, and the things would just fall out whenever I dropped the bag. Also, the shoulder strap would not stay on my shoulder due to the thickness, so I just stopped using it. So I ended up selling that one too. The next bag I sold was a Mansur Gabriel tote bag in pebble leather. You know, I really love the look and the slouchiness of the bag, and it fit a lot of things, but it had no structure and it would just fall on the ground, and because the leather was so thin, the shape would look kind of weird depending on what you put in the bag, and it was kind of pain to store this bag. So I kind of stopped using it, and then I had to let it go. The next bag I sold was Coach Cassie. I know, I have an extensive review video of Cassie and talked about how much I love this bag. I really love this Cassie bag a lot, the style and the color, capacity, and it was really easy to style, and it fit quite a bit for the size. However, as I have mentioned in the previous video, the length of the strap was kind of long and the bag was kind of boxy when I wore it as a crossbody. So when the bag is full, it would swing to the front and hang on my body, like kind of weird. And when I walk, it would hit my hip area and be uncomfortable to wear. So even though I love the style, it wasn't as comfortable to wear, so I ended up selling it. But I was very hesitant, and I thought about it for a long time before I let it go because I really liked the style a lot, but I wasn't really using it. You know, it was just sitting in my closet, so I wanted to find a new home and have it used every day. The next bag I sold was an Apache Genevieve bag in mini size. I love the minimalist look, and the cognac leather was so beautiful. However, it was too small and the leather was kind of stiff and it scratched very easily. And the top of the strap would get scratched on the metal holder every time I moved the strap, so I kind of avoided using the bag. Even though I love the look and the style, I just wasn't using it, so I ended up selling the bag. But it was a beautiful bag, you guys. Now I know that I'm not a smooth leather person. It was a good experience and lesson learned. The next two items are SLGs. The first one I sold was a Dior car holder. This one, I loved it a lot too and had it for about a year. This car holder was beautiful and it fit so many cards, like up to 20. And sometimes I would use it as a pouch because it had a lot of room. And the wear and tear was great for the canvas. However, it was a little too bulky for my bags, especially for my mini bags. So then I got a thin car holder and I was not really using this one anymore. I would have kept it, but I don't like keeping things that I don't use. So I ended up selling it and used that money towards a new bag. But if you're looking for a car holder that could hold a lot of cards and pretty. I highly recommend this one because it was not only beautiful, but the wear and tear was amazing. And I got so many compliments every time I took it out from my purse. So if you're looking for something like this, I highly recommend. The next one was a Louis Vuitton 6 key holder. I've had this key holder about 2 years and used it every single day. I got it from eBay and actually had it reglazed by Louis Vuitton because the glazing was kind of detaching from the canvas. I honestly love this thing and used it every day, and I kept my credit card and driver license in the back slot, and it was very handy. But I only had one key, and my car key was always out hanging like this, and it was kind of taking a lot of room in my mini bags, and it was a little bit boxy and bulky to use it over time. And if I had a lot of keys, then it made sense for me to keep it, but I only had one key and my car key was always out. So, and then I got card case for my phone. So I just put my credit card and driver license in my phone wallet. So I just didn't need this one anymore. So I ended up selling it. So that is it, you guys. I hope you enjoyed this video and I hope it was helpful. Let me know if you have any other questions in the comments below. I'm happy to answer. And please don't forget to subscribe. And thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.